So an active harmonic filter is more of a system solution. Let's talk about how they work. Now, if you take a look at this, basically you have harmonics coming out of the load from the right, from the nonlinear load, which would be a drive. And in the middle part, we have the active harmonic filter, which is kind of like a noise cancellation system that injects equal and opposite frequencies of everything but the 60 hertz. And in fact, it also can inject a little bit of 60 hertz current to correct the power factor. So what's left coming from the source or flowing back to the utility, so to speak, is only the nice clean 60 hertz and also right in phase. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at an active harmonic filter and we're going to do a demonstration of it actually running. So what I'll do first is this is the filter. I'm going to turn on four variable frequency drives and run all of those drives and show you what that looks like on the waveform. So we have our typical six pulse drives. We have our fifth and seventh, 11th and 13th harmonic. For example, our fifth harmonic is here, seventh. So you can see a significant amount of harmonic current and our total harmonic distortion. Now we'll take a look at the waveform. For voltage and current, and then I'll come over and I'll turn on the active harmonic filter. Now what the active harmonic filter will do will again inject equal and opposite harmonics to cancel out what's there. And if we take a look at the waveform now, it's nice and clean and also again in phase. So we'll go back to the harmonic spectrum, take a look at the currents. The distortion is very, very low. And what's happening when we do that is we're actually injecting this current, which is kind of a crazy looking frequency to cancel out what's there from the normal system harmonics. And then what I'll do is I'll turn off the active filter and you'll see the harmonic spectrum come back to normal. So if you take a look at an active harmonic filter, it works good as a system solution. It's probably the most expensive harmonic solution, but from a system standpoint, let's say redundancy in drives. You have five drives that run all the time, five drives as backup. Maybe this might be a good system solution to capture any and all of the harmonics coming from the loads. Now there is one catch to using these as far as thinking about it from a system design standpoint, and that is your drive should have either a DC choke or an AC line reactor to minimize the harmonics coming out of the drives. That way when you use this, you can make this smaller. They typically come in 50 or 60, 100, 200 amp, 300 amp units, and then you can parallel them. The other nice thing about these is you can't overload them, because once they stop putting out the amount of harmonic current that they can put out or the power factor correction they put out, they stop producing at that level, whether it's 100 amps or 120 amps or whatever the case may be. So again, active harmonic systems, active harmonic filters from a system level solution for harmonics.